Great Purple Edge here. Today I'm gonna show you how I made my own portable Do Not Touch My Stuff alarm. Sometimes you need to protect your favorite toy or special cookie from sneaky siblings, not that I have any, or parents. I wanted to keep my stuff safe, so I decided to make a portable Do Not Touch My Stuff alarm from an Adafruit Circuit Playground. It's basically an alarm that goes off if someone tries to move your stuff. This alarm won't really stop people from taking your stuff, it just makes it a tad harder to do it unnoticed. This project involves only a tiny bit of solder, which is optional. Most of it is just coding, so it should be a relatively easy project for anyone to try. The main hardware I'll need is an Adafruit Circuit Playground Classic or Express, a 3D printed case, a 500 milliamp LiPo battery, and lastly, some slide switches and wires. That's it. Any other bits and links will be listed in the description below. So let's begin! The heart of this project is the Circuit Playground Express. It's an all-in-one board with a bunch of built-in sensors and LEDs. So basically, without doing any soldering, you have access to a motion sensor, light sensor, sound sensor, temperature sensor, and RGB NeoPixel LEDs. You can further make connections to other inputs or outputs with standard alligator clips. For this project, I will be mainly using motion sensors and LEDs. For future versions, I might incorporate the other sensors, but for now, these will be all I need. For the coding, I decided to try using MakeCode, but you can also use CircuitPython, Arduino, EDU blocks, and code.org. MakeCode is a block-based coding environment in JavaScript programming, so you don't really need to type any code to experiment and put projects together. Yay! But you can still go into the script level to learn and make changes if you need to. There are lots of example projects that you can check out and learn from.
For more in-depth instruction on how to use your Circuit Playground Express, Adafruit has lesson number 0 that walks you through everything.
My code is basically divided up into sections. The first section is the parameters that are initiated when the program starts. The second section waits until button A is pressed, then counts down, detects, and records motion sensors' static state. I set up the LEDs to count down from 10 once the button is pressed to give you some time before it's armed. Once it's armed, the program will move on to the final section. The code will repeatedly compare the current motion sensor data against the recorded static state. If it's not the same, it will trigger the alarm code. To turn off the alarm, you just need to press button B. And if you want to reuse the alarm, just press button A and the process starts again.
Using MakeCode, I was able to use the built-in simulator to test out the code before sending it into the Circuit Playground. This made it easier to try things over and over again. Also, depending on your situation, you can add in a bit of buffer for the recorded data to use so you won't have any false alarms like a person walking by or a strong breeze. Now, off to the case.
I used the Circuit Playground case files by Adafruit that you can find on the Thingiverse as the base of my design. I created a few designs that I've traced in Fusion 360 to create what I wanted. Another thing that I tried to do was to have buttons that you could press on the outside of the case. I created buttons that would be held in place by the snap fit case against the board.
To be able to turn the alarm on and off, I needed to solder a switch in line with the battery.
This just needs a bit of simple soldering. It is basically just measuring wires to the right length, and then soldering, and then heat shrinking.
That's all the soldering needed. Your project will still work out without it. You will just need to connect the battery direct to power the Circuit Playground, and disconnect it when you're ready to turn it off. On to the final assembly.
First, connect the battery to the switch wires, then connect the Circuit Playground, and give everything a quick test to make sure it all works. Then put them into the bottom of the kit. Attach your custom lid or even the standard lid into place.
That's it. Add my very own portable Do Not Touch My Stuff alarm to keep my things safe. If you like this video, please give me a like. And for more videos like this one, hit that subscribe button to my channel, Purple Oranji. Also, click that little bell icon to get a reminder of my new videos. That's all for now. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye! Cut!